Hello, Patriots. I just wanted to wish you all a welcome back from our wonderful snow break of 4 days. I hope everyone had a chance to relax and get outside and play a little bit, make some snow angels. Anyway, I want to remind everybody, with those missed days come our makeup days. So February 15th, which was the day that we were supposed to be in school already, doing professional development, is now a school day with students. April 1st, which was a green day that you would be working from home, is a day now for students and staff to be on campus. Spring break week will not be touched. And also June 6th and June 7th are now days with students and staff on campus. So that's been sent out through media outlets. We've sent it out a lot of different ways internally as well. Just please make sure you and you're helping the students plan accordingly, that those are now 4 days that we will make up for our snow day. So, in addition, before we continue on with our virtual faculty meeting, just want to remind everybody that the school board is taking a very good, serious look at the overcrowding situation here at Albemarle High School. It's only projected to get worse over the years. So they are talking about different possibilities. We've shared some of those with you. The one I think that is getting a fair amount of traction is the module units. So we'll continue to have conversations. But again, these are all just possibilities at this time. And we're sharing out the ideas as they come through so that they can be explored. Once we find out specifically what will be done with the overcrowding to help alleviate some of the stress here next year, then we can start getting with everybody and start planning rooms, room assignments, and things like that. So we'll keep you posted. But I have had a lot of interest in people from the community, school board members coming out and touring the building to see how overcrowded we are. And it's been very, very impactful on the people that have come. I've already had several school board members come. I've got a planning meeting with another school board member who wants to tour the school. And the things I shared with them the most are the stresses that you guys have as staff members that people don't see day in and day out. For instance, not being able to stay in your classroom and close your door and plan and grade papers and make private phone calls to families has become extremely difficult. So now, in the very limited spaces we do have for staff members that can't use their own classrooms to go to, what happens is there's multiple people in there. And what I've tried to share with them is what happens when there's multiple people sitting in a room together. There's conversations that are happening, they're talking, and they're socializing, a natural thing that would happen. Why is that a stress? Well, now all of a sudden my staff members need to take their work home. They need to do more grading at home, more planning at home. And it's just a continued stress. And those are the things I've been emphasizing to the school board and the members of the community that have come around and shared with them. We have very limited space here. Even a child finding a teacher and where they are, it can become very difficult at times. So those are the things that we've shared. You know, in light of that, I continue to share that we're doing some wonderful things. You guys are doing some wonderful things. From the interdisciplinary team approach to re-engaging some kids in our ninth grade year with Team 19, which will continue into their sophomore year, and we'll have a new group coming in for next year. To the changes that are being made to reach some of our biggest gap groups that we're having in ESOL and special education, we're doing some wonderful things, specifically in the math department, where we're seeing some large growth in the number of students that are passing classes and SOLs and engaging with the curriculum. And we're continuing to chip away at the deficits we had and keep our pulse on the wonderful things that you guys do day in and day out that we share at the state of the school and throughout the year. So just wanted to let you know that we are working on it. We'll keep you posted as things come up. But thank you for all your hard work. We appreciate everything you do. And I wanted to end with talking about the pathways. As you know, we started an Arts and Letters pathway several years ago, and that's expanded. Next year, there'll be actually up to 15 Arts and Letters pathways that kids can choose through with entry points in both 9th and 10th grade. In addition, we're going to be implementing a STEM pathway next year, science, technology, engineering, and mathematics, that we're really excited about. It's also a partnership that the kids can actually take classes over at K-Tech and still be a STEM pathway completer here at Albemarle. So all that information is on our website. We've already shared it with all the teachers that will be impacted at the middle school, recommending kids here. We've gone to the middle school, and all of our staff members here have been a part of developing their pathways out as well. So we're really excited about it. If you have any questions, let us know. Thank you.
Hello, AHS team members. After much time and debate, we have definitely come up with a plan for addressing tardies to class here at Albemarle High School. As you all may have already known, some of our students received one of these great notifications during second quarter to alert them of how many tardies they had accumulated and how many hours of detention they would have to give back to us. I am very happy to report that the word is getting out. Students are definitely not so happy receiving these, and they have been given their time for the tardies. As we've started the third quarter, I just wanted to give a few reminders about how we will operate our tardy policy from here on out. All of my teacher colleagues, you're reminded to make sure that when you are in Power School doing attendance, you do mark students tardy who are showing up as tardy. But the first tardy, give them a warning to let them know it's being logged and we're looking at them. For the second tardy, if you can initiate contact with the parent or guardian, whether it's via phone or email, that will be great. And with the third tardy, on our end, through the attendance office, we'll catch them and we'll begin to assign hours for detention. What we do is for every third tardy, we convert that to an absence. And that absence will turn into 1 hour of detention that they will owe us. So tardies are being kept, students are serving, and we are delighted. The overall push with our operation for tardies is to make sure our students are getting to class on time. So do encourage them to get to class and to be on time, and hopefully our numbers of tardies will continue to decrease. Thank you for all of your help.
It's performance task assessment prep time. Groups who are required to give the performance task assessment need to be making sure that students have completed it and that they have it submitted before we go on spring break, before April 1st. We're going to be scoring it similarly to how we did it last year, using scoring teams, and Tony will talk about the scoring.
So we're going to do it on April 19th and 20th. It's a 3.5 hour commitment. It'll be from 4 to 7:30. When you sign up, you have to sign up for both time slots at the same time. You can assess outside of your endorsement area. So if you're going to assess government, you don't have to be a government teacher. Let's see. There'll be a form sent out later on by the administration you sign up on.
We'll provide dinner for both nights.
And you do get paid for the extra time.
Yeah, you get paid. And you have to commit for both scoring sessions. So Mr. Thomas, I think, one of the administrators will send out a link with a Google sign up so that you can sign up to do the scoring. Everyone needs to remember to actually give the assessments to their students, and we'll follow up with more about how the scoring teams work in a future faculty meeting, probably.
In addition to everything that we're doing on campus for Black History Month, I also want to let my colleagues know about an opportunity that's happening in the division. We're hosting a division diversity resource teacher retreat, and it is open for everyone who wants to come. We'd love an AHS cohort of teachers to come, because what we'll be talking about that day is culturally responsive teaching. For instance, looking at your own cultural lens and using instructional strategies in the classroom to benefit our ever-growing number of diverse students in our school. We also have a session on how to ensure equitable parent participation amongst our diverse families as well. So the retreat is February 8th, and if you need any more information, you can come and see me anytime. My name is Leilani Keys, and I'm in room 232, and we'd love for you to make it.
Patriots, two announcements. One, the school board has just voted to make March 1st, which is a presidential primary, a day off for students. We have decided to make that a green work day countywide for staff. So on March 1st, there will be no school. That day will not need to be made up. I did push that out in your calendars. You can read the press release that went along with it. But students will not be on campus that day, and that will be a green work day. You will be working from home that day. In addition, next week, the first week of February, you will be getting a letter from Human Resources or Lorna Jeromes, and I'm going to read a little bit about what this will be about. It's very important. It's about the Dependent Eligibility Verification Program. Next week, all employees with dependents on medical plan will receive a letter from Human Resources explaining the program. This will be followed by an email that will be directed to the HMS in mid-February. All employees who have a dependent, a spouse or a child, enrolled on their medical plan are required to participate. If an employee does not comply, your dependents will be dropped from the plan. So this is extremely important. I just wanted to reemphasize to you guys, when you get this email, it is very important to either ask questions and make sure you comply and get this information in. If you have any question, once it comes out, come see me. I'll be glad to help you. Thank you.